Hey everyone, Kevin here. Today, we'll look at how you can set up your own Minecraft server on your PC, invite your friends, and start playing, even if your friends are on a completely different network. Best of all, this is completely free. This works with the Minecraft Java Edition. Let's dive in. First off, head to the following website. You can navigate to the link at the bottom of the screen. This is the official Minecraft server download website. Once again, we're setting up the Java Edition server. If you want to play with friends on consoles or mobile devices, you might want to consider the Bedrock Edition instead. You'll find a link at the bottom of the screen. All right, let's download the server. Let's click on this link, and that'll give you the latest version. And just as a heads up, if you're watching this later, the version number that you see here may have changed. Click on this, and that'll kick off the download right here. Once it's done downloading, let's open up this file in File Explorer. This opens up my downloads folder, and here I see that file server.jar. The downloads folder is not the most permanent place, so I'd rather place this file elsewhere. I'll select the file and let's copy it. I'll place it on my desktop. I'll click into the desktop and over here, let's create a new folder. I'll go down to new and let's select folder. And here I could enter in a folder name. I'll call this Minecraft server. Now let's click into that new folder and in here I'll paste that file server.jar. Next, let's go up to the address bar up on top. Click in here and then type in cmd. This will open up command prompt in this current directory. Then hit enter. Before we can run the server, we need to make sure that we have Java installed. We are, after all, installing the Java Edition server. To check if you have Java installed, within command prompt, type in this command, java-version. You'll find all the commands in the description of this video. Once you enter this in, hit enter. It looks like I don't have Java installed, which is not a problem. It's really easy to install it. Right down here, let's type in the following command, winget install microsoft.openjdk.21. We're going to use the Windows Package Manager to install Java, and this is Microsoft's version of Java. It's an open source version of the Java development kit, and version 21 is currently the most recent version. Once you enter this in, press enter. Right down below, it looks like it was successfully installed. We're making good progress. In the top right-hand corner, let's now close out of this window. Within the address bar, let's type in cmd again, and this will once again open up command prompt. Within command prompt, right up on top, let's type in java-version, hit enter, and we can now confirm that Java was successfully installed. Now that we confirmed that we have Java installed, let's run the server. I'll type in this command. Again, you can find all the commands in the description of this video. Once you type this in, hit enter. A whole bunch of text pops up on the screen, and here at the very bottom, we see an error message saying that we need to agree to the EULA in order to run the server. So how do we do that? Well, let's minimize this command prompt window. You'll notice that it has now generated a number of additional files, and one of them is titled EULA.txt. Let's click on this file. This opens up Notepad, where we can make edits to this file. At the very bottom, it says EULA equals false. We need to change this to say true. This signifies that we have read and understood this end user agreement. Of course, we've all read this file. Once you're done making your changes, go up to File, Save, and then close out of this window. Let's now switch back into the command prompt window. Within command prompt, let's now try launching the server again. I'll go all the way down to the bottom and I'll enter in this command. You can find this in the description and then hit enter. You may see a Windows security message. I'll click on allow. And look at that, we now have a basic Minecraft server up and running. Congratulations. Hopefully that wasn't too hard. Of course, you probably don't want to have to go into command prompt every single time that you want to launch your server. And you may also want to configure some of your server settings. Let's do that. Right up above, let's close out of the server and let's also close command prompt. Back within File Explorer, we're going to create what's called a batch file, and this will simplify starting your server. Basically, we'll just have one file that we could click on, and that will launch your Minecraft server. So how do we do that? Well, right up on top, let's start by clicking on the View menu. Then all the way down at the bottom, we have this option called Show. Make sure that there's a check mark next to this item titled File Name Extensions. We need to be able to modify the file name extension. If that's turned on, click out of that, and then right-click within File Explorer. That opens up the context menu, and then you have an option for New. Let's hover over that, and we're going to add a new text document. Click on this. This has now added a new file, newtextdocument.txt, but that's not going to work. Let's highlight all of that text and in place of it, type in start.bat. This is going to be a batch file. Then press enter. We get a warning message that tells us if we change a file name extension, the file might become unstable. We're good with that, so let's click on yes. Let's now go over to this new file that we just added, right-click on it, and then let's select Edit in Notepad. Within Notepad, let's paste in the following code. Again, you'll find this in the description of this video. Let's have a quick look at what this file is doing. Right up on top, we have a command echo off. This will make the command prompt window cleaner when we run it. Down below, this will launch the server. And right at the beginning, we have two different properties. We can define how much RAM we want to allocate to our Minecraft server. Right over here, you could set the minimum amount of RAM. And right here, the XMX allows you to assign the maximum amount of RAM. So right here, I've assigned 2 gigabytes as the minimum and 4 gigabytes of RAM or memory as the maximum. So how do you know how much RAM you can assign to your server? Let's press Control Shift Escape on your keyboard, and that'll open up Task Manager. Let's click into the performance category, then click into memory. Here you'll see how much memory is currently being used on your computer and how much RAM or memory you have available. Now, in this case, I'm using 15 gigabytes of RAM and I have 128 gigabytes available. So here within Notepad, I could set a much higher number as my maximum RAM. Right over here, let's close out of this window. Now, instead of 4 gigabytes, let me set it to 8 gigabytes, but I could also set it much higher. Then lastly, we also say to pause. What this will do is this prevents the command prompt window from closing if the server crashes. And this is helpful if you want to read any error messages. Once you've entered in all these lines in your file, let's go to File and then Save, and then you can close out of this window. Let's now look at how you can modify some of the server properties. Right down below, let's click on this file titled server.properties. When you click on this, we need to select an app to open this file. Let's go with Notepad. Down below, let's click on Always. This opens up all of the different settings, and you can modify any of these. For example, here we have the difficulty. Currently, it's set to easy. If we go down a little bit more, currently the game mode is set to survival, but maybe you prefer creative, you can simply change that right in here. Now, there are all sorts of different settings. If you want a full overview of what all these different settings are and what you can set them to, check out the link down below in the description. Once you're done making all of your changes to this file, go up to File, Save, and then you can close out of this. Let's now start the server. Because we set up that batch file, it's really easy. Let's simply go down to our file titled start.bat and then double click on it. This has now launched our server. Now, one other thing, if you want to run commands in game, for example, if you want to teleport or change the time or the weather, you'll want to make yourself an operator. To do that, over on the right-hand side in this text field, type in /OP, OP for operator, and then type in your in-game name. Once you do that, hit enter. And right up above, I can see that I am now a server operator. Now that the server's running, let's jump into Minecraft to see how we can connect to the server. To connect to your server from the same computer it's running on, within Minecraft, let's click on multiplayer. Over here, I'll click on proceed. Down below, let's click on direct connection. And over here, you could enter in a server address. Type in localhost and then click on join server. And check that out, we're now in Minecraft. Let's now look at how you can connect from another computer on the same network. To connect from another computer on the same network, in File Explorer, let's go back up to the address bar and then type in CMD to open up command prompt. Within command prompt, right here, type in ipconfig and then press enter. You'll see a whole bunch of different numbers, but the one that we're looking for is the IPv4 address. This is your computer's IP address on your local network. Highlight this address and then press Control C to copy. Then we could close out of command prompt. Open up an app like Notepad, and right over here, let's paste in the IP address that we found with ipconfig. Then we're going to append the port number. I'll append the port number. This is the default port. You can change this within the server.properties, but I didn't make any changes. I left it to the default. And if you didn't make any changes, this should be your port as well. Then copy this address and provide it to any of your friends who are on the same network who want to play Minecraft with you. Within Minecraft, they can simply click on multiplayer, click on proceed, and then click on direct connection. Then enter in that address, the IP address, along with the port, and then click on join server, and they will also be able to join your game of Minecraft and join your server. Next, we're going to look at how someone on an external network can connect to your server. Back within command prompt, let's type in that same command again, ipconfig, and then press enter. Right down here, you'll see something called the default gateway, also with an IP address. Typically, this is your router's IP address. Copy this value and then close out of command prompt. Open up a browser window and then in the address field, paste in that IP address that we just copied from command prompt and then press enter. This should bring you to your router's login page. Now, your page probably looks different than mine. It depends on what type of router you have. You may have a Netgear login page, a Linksys, or a D-Link login page. Right up on top, type in your username or your email address and your password, and then click on sign in. Once you finish signing in, see if you could find your WAN IP address. This stands for the Wide Area Network. It's basically the IP address that your internet provider assigns. It's your external IP address. Right over here, I see my WAN IP. I'll copy this value. Then let's go down to settings. Within settings, see if you could find a setting for port forwarding. Right up on top, I'll search through all my different settings for port forwarding. And right down here, I see an option for it. I'll click on this. On this screen, we can set up port forwarding. This opens up a specific port on your router, which allows your friends or external players to connect to your Minecraft server by directing their traffic to your computer. Without it, your router would block all these incoming connections, which would prevent your friends from joining your server from outside your network. Right up on top, we can give this port forwarding rule a name. I'll call this Minecraft server. Down below, we can see our external IP address. Right down here, you can also set up the WAN port. I'm going to go with the default port provided by Minecraft, 25565. Right down below, I'll set it to any. Now, we have to indicate where we want to forward this, or basically where your computer is. And this is the IP address of your computer. So right here, I'll enter in my IP address that we looked at earlier from ipconfig. Then we also need to enter in the forward port. Here too, I'll enter in the default value of 25565. For the protocol, I'll set this to TCP UDP. This is all that I need to configure. Down below, we can now click on add entry. And right here, I can confirm that my port forwarding is now enabled. For someone externally to be able to join your Minecraft game, they'll need to enter in your WAN IP address, followed by a colon, and then the port number. One thing to note, internet service providers frequently change your external IP address. In fact, with this video, you may think this is my IP address, but since filming, it's now changed. So if you're using this server often, you may need to update your friends on what your latest WAN IP address is. Let's now test this out. I'm on a computer on a different network. Down below, let's click on Direct Connection. And over here, enter in your WAN IP address. This is your external IP address, followed by a colon and then the port number. Then let's click on Join Server. And look at that. We are now in Minecraft on an external network on my Minecraft server. Pretty cool. Now, especially if you're connecting to lots of different servers, you might just want to add this server. Down over here, we could click on Add Server. You can give the server a name. Then you could also type in the address. And over here, click on Done, and that will now add this server to your list of servers. All right, now you just need friends to play with. And honestly, that might be harder than setting up the server. Anyway, if this helped you, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.